Hey everybody, it's Victa. It's time to continue the streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you everybody for the support. As always, 367 wins in a row. And also, of course, the like streak continues to 50. We're down to almost 9 days out. Today is going to be 2 Bravo Victor, November, Hotel 6, Sierra 6. We've got good tiers, average damage, bad movement speed, good range, and a good space bar item. Decent amount of HP too. 1 key, no bombs. Yeah. A lot of people were upset about the fact that I didn't use the strength card. I'm pretty sure that I admitted that I goofed that up. But then somebody asked, how come I didn't use... Why did you not use the strength card in yesterday's run for Mega Satan? And it's because I was trying to preserve the Polar Invincibility that we had. I believe that we were going for that on that run anyway. I mean, look, it's been 24 hours since I last played that run, so you'll have to forgive me. My memory is not nearly what it used to be. And on top of that, I play a lot of Isaac. I don't know if you... I'm not sure if you've known that or not, but... occasionally, whenever you're recording Isaac every single day of like every single week of every year, a lot of the runs do kind of sort of blend in together. So, forgive me if I'm getting my facts sort of not straight whenever I'm retroactively talking about questions. I mean, yes, it was only 24 hours ago, but you have to remember I've sort of not slept since then. we're now back into the temperatures that it's not cool enough outside to be comfortable in my room without air conditioner, but it's not hot enough outside to trigger the air conditioner. Again, one of the many reasons why I just got to get my own place. I mean, I'm working on it. Trust me, I'm working on it. Now that tax season is beyond us, I hopefully can make up what I had to spend on taxes this year within the next paycheck, I'm hoping. So if all goes well for that, then, you know, then maybe. So, and I know that people were sending condolences about the house. I really like that house. I was really looking forward to being in that house, but it just didn't work out. It's sort of like, and what I told my realtor was that, you know, I was going into that with the attitude that I wasn't going to fall in love with the house, because it's sort of like falling in love with a puppy that you're not sure you're going to be able to bring back from the shelter, you know. And then by the time you get back there and, you know, you're like, hey, I'm ready to take the puppy, and someone else has gotten it, then, well, you're done after that, you know. So I didn't do that. I mean, I was halfway expecting to not get the house, but that's okay. It was definitely a house that I could potentially afford. But right now, like, right now, all I want really is just a comfortable house that I can keep at a nice temperature. It's not like, you know, the backside of like a dumpster. If I can get something like that and be able to afford it, then you know what? Yeah, I'm going to take black lipstick, because we might as well, since we have the belly button. Belly button allows us to carry 2 trinkets instead of 1. About it. So we really needed to get some stats off of that boss or this first item room, and we did not. So the iron bar that we have, that will do a concussive shot, which staggers or dazes an enemy, depending on how you want to say it. Finally get a bomb. I'm not going to go to the secret room, which is to the left of here. I am going to go back up here and get this tinted rock and hopefully get a little bit more soul heart help. Am I imagining things, or was there... I could have sworn there was a... Yeah, there it is. Okay. Whew, I'm not going crazy. Look, I'm taking it. I know it's going to nuke our movement speed, but we have the damage and the DPS to deal with this. On top of that, we have to remember that the sprinkler is also going to help us with DPSing, so I'm not going to complain about our movement speed, at least not right now anyway, because I did it to myself, but we already had bad movement speed. What's another minus 0.2? You know, anything under 1 is going to feel pretty much the same. The important thing is that we have the damage to give us the illusion of survivability. So even though our positioning won't be perfect in this run, which it's not, at least we have the damage to protect ourselves. If we can't rely on one thing, so we have to rely on another. In this case, it's going to be our damage and our tears. Normally, I'd say it's probably worth at least trying to fish for Magic Mush. This time around, I'm not going to do that because we're going to need to go into the store and hopefully get something. We need to get... Restock would be nice. Now, I'm not going to use our only two bombs right now because I'm going to wait. Because we don't know what else... There might be a couple chests over here that's, you know, locked behind rocks or something. We also have those golden chests inside the boss trap room as well. It's something to consider. Now, the key opens up another golden chest. Okay. So now we make a decision. Let's see how much we get for one, and then we're going to have to save the other bomb. The reason restock is so important here is because this is floor two that we're talking about. And having restock this early would be huge, but first, we need to fight the boss. Hopefully not Champion Ragman. And it's not. We did get Mysterious Liquid, of course, which is going to give us that little toxic pool underneath our tears whenever they land a... They connect with a shot on an enemy. So the sprinkler system is just going to fire off a bunch of random shots in a clockwise pattern, which is very good. It does stack with your damage, and if you have ways to summon more than one, then you can. Get basically no stat ups of note. And a guppy item. Say so long to the sprinkler. Now, some people are going to be bent out of shape that I'm not taking the sprinkler here. The sprinkler is a good item. I just want to say that right now. It's a good item. But given the fact that because our movement speed is so limited right now, even more so, of course, after I took Small Rock, the flies are going to keep us much safer per room than the sprinkler will. Does that make sense? Like, we gain a more immediate benefit out of having... I should have blown up the other one. That skull there. We gain a more immediate benefit in having guppy flies than we do with the sprinkler. Now, yes, the sprinkler overall does way more damage. But practicality-wise, it's better for us to have an item that we can benefit from right now. We get 12 cents here. Which is not enough for us to get... restock. Did gain a double bomb here at the very end. A Hierophant, and of course didn't have any money in there. So we have to hope that... That was Little Baggy, by the way. I'm not going to take Little Baggy because A, I don't take pills, and B, it takes all pills and turns them... Or takes all cards and runes and turns them into pills. So again, counterintuitive. We have to hope that this bomb gives us 3 cents off of our donation machine. Another penny there would be nice. Okay. 3 cents, please. Got 4 cents. Good. Good, good, good. Okay, so that's a key element in this run right now, is having the ability to rebuy stuff in the store whenever we need to. So what restock will do is it will essentially reload any item that you buy. So that soul heart you saw there respawned while it was sitting in the shop. You can do that infinitely as long as you have the money to pay for it. You can do that with premium items as well. Overall, it's a good start. And another Curse of the Labyrinth. I'm pretty sure this is like the third or fourth run that we've had in a row with Curse of the XL. So... Once again, we have a situation where we cannot afford to get screwed here thanks to Curse of the XL. And what I mean by that is because we have a Curse of the Labyrinth, that automatically takes away one shop. So already we're down. It takes away one devil deal if we qualified for one. And let me be clear, we're not guaranteed to lose a devil deal because, of course, we don't know if we got one or not. But that's not the point. The point that I argue whenever I don't, the reason why I hate Curse of the Labyrinth is because it takes the choice, it takes the opportunity away from you, regardless of what you want to or what or don't want to happen. You know, if we didn't have Curse of the Labyrinth, we would get an extra shop, we would get an extra chance to get a deal with the devil, we would get an extra map that we could possibly spawn, like a library or a dice room, something like that, special rooms, sacrifice rooms, etc. You see what I mean? So having Curse of the Labyrinth takes away a lot of the benefits of clearing rooms individually rather than lumping them all up. A lot of people, to the usually newer players, they say, what's the big deal? Like, why? Like, you get to progress faster through the game. Why is that a big deal? It's a big deal not because of progression, but because of your item progression. and or the lack thereof. And another thing you have to consider is that if you get an XL floor that gives you nothing and you're already weak on a run, remember all those rooms that I just got done telling you how we lose all that stuff? That becomes even more of a bigger issue for you and potentially very dangerous. Because now you're talking about a situation where you have a run that you do not have, you're not capable of defending yourself adequately. I should save the bombs. We're gonna need the bombs to get money out of the donation machine. I thought about rerolling Tough Love there. We only have 0.15 on our luck, so it's very unlikely we're gonna spawn that many teeth. But this bomb is gonna be much more useful in the hands of us going after either the Seeker Room, which is below us here, or actually, there's no, this is Super Seeker Room. Taking a risk here. Ragman, but there is a lot of money. Thank you, Infamy, by the way. Well, I mean, not a lot of money, but it's money. Okay, so we're looking for a lot of money here. That's not really any. One bomb. All right. I mean, most people understand what I'm saying. Occasionally, people will say, oh, you're just making too much of a big deal out of it, but it's a difference of opinion, I guess. I look at the bigger picture in situations like this where we say, hey, I don't like that the game took something from me or didn't give me a chance to do something or have something. You know, that's the big problem. And then again, if you're starting with a very weak run, I'm not speaking specifically of this run, I'm saying overall, if we had a really weak run that we truly needed or desperate for any sort of stat ups at all, and then we get hit with a curse of the XL or curse of the labyrinth, you know, then we're talking about, and we don't get anything off of that floor, we're talking about big time danger. Absolutely take flat penny here. By the way, we have not had a single black soul heart spawn off the lipstick, just throwing it out there, game. Of course, our luck is terrible. I don't know how much of that's luck-based, but this is Invicta luck we're talking about. So the flat penny will give us a chance of spawning a key every time we pick up a coin. Mystery Sack is just going to give us something occasionally. Sometimes it can give you life. Sometimes it can give you bombs, trinkets. It's not bad. Not bad for a passive item. I mean, it's a passive item that rewards you every now and then. Before we fight this boss, though, we need to go find where the shop is and we'll go see what's inside of it. Now, if this is a greed fight, then you know for sure that the game is really trying to screw us here. A floor 3 and floor 4 XL floor with a greed fight in the store is a surefire sign of Isaac is truly trying to screw you. And what's going to be even worse is if we get nothing from the bosses and we don't get a double deal. I mean, we need a red heart HP first, so. Okay, I'm going to take a risk here and grab that. I was really hoping it was going to be the two of diamonds, obviously. I think the smart thing here is to... Oh, the two of diamonds. Well, then. I'm going to take a risk. This is only a risk because I want the soul heart, but, like... I'm looking for blank card if possible. Nun's Habit doesn't help us, and there's no soul heart here. Nun's Habit, Guppy's Head is very good. Yes, okay, another two of diamonds. Good, good, good. Okay, so now we can take Nun's Habit. Do not take Sharp Plug. I almost walked over that. The mystery gift is tempting, but I think I'm gonna play it safe and just go for 3 soul hearts here. A half-price tarot card. Wheel of Fortune. Okay. Not over yet. Get a 7-cent blue map, which would not be bad at all. Okay, so Nun's Habit will recharge 1 charge on your spacebar item for the damage that you take. And given the fact that we have Guppy's Head, that means every time we get hit, we're still going to be able to retaliate by throwing out a... couple of attack flies. Now, this is most likely the regular secret room here. I would really like to get 5 more cents because the blue map on this run would be very beneficial for us. We need to have absolute accuracy in our secret rooms. Because we need, right now we're looking for any advantage that we can get. Our damage, yes, while it is sufficient, is going to start falling off when we get to the womb. And obviously, I mean, I think it's gone more than a fair amount of time now for me to say it, but hopefully we are able to make up some movement speed. I do feel I can sort of complain about the movement speed just because we did start with an abysmally low rate anyway. I'm going to take a risk here and go into the curse room. If anything, this at least charges Guppy's head and gives us a little bit of extra flies to deal with the boss. Ansa's doesn't really help us here. Stick with Ansa's. I'm just looking for 3 more cents, game. Or sorry, 5 more cents. Not 3 more cents. And now the dream is dead because we got hit by a greed head. Okay. Yes, I could go back and grab the death card and use it on the boss, then come back out and get the Ansa's rune, but... Eh. By the way, apologies if you hear a fan blowing. I'm not sure if you can or not, but it's very hot in my room. As I stated at the beginning of this run, it's very, very hot. Got to 81 today. Like, what in the world, game? Real life game. 81 outside. Fahrenheit, for those of you who are not American. Not 81 Celsius. 81 Celsius, I'm pretty sure everyone would be dead. So, whenever you're facing Mag Rega, the best thing to do is to not try to shoot the purple balls, just sort of loop-de-loop them around like I did. And we get Carrion Queen. Luckily, we have Toxic, Mysterious Liquid, which is the direct counter to Carrion Queen here. Oh, we got the champion one, actually. The champion one's not as bad because you get to shoot the hearts instead of actually going for her rear end. Didn't actually know those things shot. Ironically, for this build, this is not a great matchup for us. It's a lot easier when we get the regular Carrion Queen. We're really pushing it with these close calls here with his movement speed. Of course, we did get a luck upgrade from Magic Scab, so that does help with our DPS for Tough Love. And Spider Bite will help us with crowd control. But you see here, the damage that we're doing to Carrion Queen is not necessarily that great. If she was the non-champion version, when we can hit her rear, we would actually be able to deal our tears damage to her instead of like just the fixed amount that she loses whenever we destroy a heart. Unless, of course, the tooth does proc Mysterious Liquid, then it will scale off of that, I believe. No deal with the devil, and another non-stat up that makes any difference other than our luck, I suppose. Woo! So now we're getting to the point where it's going to start being an issue, and shout out to Curse the XL for making that happen. So not only did we, the best thing we got out of that last floor was probably the store. Like, getting Nun's Habit's nice. I mean, Tough Love and Spider Bite, of course, are great. But we can't feel good about a run like this, you know? Like, there's no clear advantage that we may have here. No, I'm not happy that we lost a full soul heart because of the mega troll bomb. There's nothing I can do about that. We need stats. We need stats that don't give us range or luck. I mean, luck upgrades are fine because we do have tough love, but it's not going to matter as much as us getting, like, say, a movement speed up or damage up. You know, tough love is great if you have the luck for it. It's certainly not an item that I would say you should be able to lean upon. It's not a hard carry item or anything like that. That was the worst damage ever. Okay. Alright. What's inside of our store? Nothing. Life is hard. It's going to be apparent. I tell you what. This is going to be pretty apparent of how bad we're off whenever you guys get to see the mom fight. Because right now, let me tell you, the mom fight's going to take quite a long time. In fact, I would even go so far as to say that we should have taken Bob's brain at this point, and that's saying a lot. So thanks to the Ansa's rune, at least, we are able to see where the Super Seeker Room and regular Seeker Rooms are. Yeah, I would have never thought it would be up here. A little bit of HP back there. I don't know what the point of that lock is, considering the fact we can't get to the chest in the first place without flying. So if we had flying, why would we ever need the... Like, we would just fly, like, past the lock. You can't bamboozle me, game. Feels like a sign. Yeah, we got our bomb back at least. I mean, keys and bombs have been plentiful here. It would take a grand total of 2 bombs, maybe 3, to clear this for keys, and I think it's worth it here. Bombs. 3 bombs for 4 keys. Still okay. You might be saying, well, you got flat penny. Why would you even do that for just the keys alone? Yeah, but you never know how many chests you're going to see. Or if flat penny pays out. Keep that in mind. So once again, we get no stat here, but we do at least get an orbital. And we know that we're guaranteed a devil deal here. Now this is going to be tough. Fighting war and trying to stay away from him with 0.68 movement speed. Luckily, Steel Bar went ham on him. We have all the bandages here. An empty vessel and little harbingers. I really don't like little harbingers, but this is kind of a worst case scenario what we're dealing with right now. So I am going to take 7 seals only because... Only because we need to activate the flying. If we can activate flying with this bad movement speed, at least that increases our mobility tenfold. And our lack of movement speed doesn't matter that much. It still matters, and it's something that we are going to have to eventually deal with. But for right now, this will do. Now, the reason why I don't like little harbingers is because of the fact that you do get the explosive flies sent to you by, I believe, war. And I'm pretty sure that most, if not everyone, knows how I feel about explosions that I can't control. We're just looking for something, game. Something here. I'm not going to take Abel. How can you don't like Abel's Invicta? Well, he's just bad. He doesn't do anything good for you. Yes, he shoots in the opposite direction, but he also makes it to where he can make you believe like you're dodging out of an enemy projectile, when in reality it's a friendly one spawned by Abel. Versus whenever he doesn't shoot, and then you think that it's a friendly target, or it's a friendly projectile, and then it turns out it's not. So it's Steam Sale, of course, is going to be very crucial to have when we have the restock. There's the explosive fly right there, which we need to be very careful of. And we got hit immediately by the first one. Thank you, War. The D in Fizzle. Let's go. Get me out of here. Strange Attractor, Little Brimstone, Goathead, Abaddon, Experimental Treatment. We also got Scorpio. We have a decent amount of damage here. Inch Nails as well. So the D Infinity will take all. We did lose Empty Vessel. It will take all dice. The D6, the D4, the D10, the D5, the D100. And it will randomly shift between all of those. Now, is this a good one to stop on? I would say so, yes, but I don't like Strange Attractor. And I think we can do a little bit better. The reason why Strange Attractor is bad is because, well, it breaks the game, essentially. It makes things move way faster than they have any right to move. It is nice for grouping stuff up, especially if you have piercing shots like we do with Death's Touch. So we need to go to the store. Now, we didn't retain Steam Sale. Steam Sale's gone. But I am A-okay with using the D-Infinity here. The only die I think that the D-Infinity won't copy is the D1. I think. Again, if you're wondering why I'm not re-rolling here, it's because I'm waiting to see what's inside of this store. So we have... We can get 30 cents here, but remember, we don't have restock anymore. So I think I'm just going to deposit and be gone. Got Maw of the freaking Void. Death's List. Eye of Belial, My Reflection, Sin Robes, Rotten Baby. What looks to like it might be half soy milk, I'm not sure. Our tears rate doesn't represent soy milk, though. We also have Dark Prince's Crown. Got the Leviathan transformation, which is nice. That's what I was waiting for. I was waiting for the explosive fly from Little Harbingers to go away. Good damage there. Hit 9 lives and the Razor Blade. Use the D8 here. It gave us a huge damage up, but not much else. We'll head on down to the next floor. So the question is, how zany are we going to get with this reroll? Now, I should make mention, in case of you all didn't see the stream or you didn't watch yesterday's episode, lately I have been losing Eden runs on stream. But the most recent loss was because I went a little bit too ham with the rerolls. I had the D Infinity. So maybe that was a foreshadowing omen to the next time that I get into this, put in this position, if I have a winning run, to stick with it. Well, I mean, Guppy's Knife, Brimstone, or Guppy's Knife. Mom's Knife, Guppy, Brimstone, Judas's freaking Shadow. and Sack Dagger. Got Ludovico, Crybaby, Depression. God, look how slow the shot speed is. 0.60. That's awful. How's our damage, though, is the thing. This is the slowest tier rate I think I've ever seen with Ludovico. That is not an exaggeration. This is pathetically slow. Where's the XL? No. Oh, dear God. We have My Reflection, Bumbo, Ipecac. But Ipecac's not exploding because we still have Mom's Knife. Hamolacria. Or not Hamolacria, but that's Lacrophagy. D20, D6, okay. So our damage is going to be quite nice, but I need to be. Let's see what we do with the matriarch. Let's see where we fight her. I also have Daddy Long Legs, but I didn't say it already. Bomb Rusher down. Yeah, My Reflection is really hurting our tier range right now. And I was really hoping that we were going to get rid of it, but another D20. I am going to re-roll this because I don't, like, this is a decent re-roll, but Skipping Stone, My Reflection is just weird. It's not working out the way that I want it to. Locus of Conquest, by the way, is our trinket that will spawn those big white flies that you see, and they deal damage. The colors don't really have any significance other than the one that war spawns, because the one that war spawns is orange, and they explode, as you've all seen already. We also have Shielded Tears, Spider Babby, Little Haunt, Leo, Little Loki. We just picked up the screw. I mean, our damage is quite nice. But it's not what I'm looking for. Not today. Here's, we also have Mom's Coin, maybe. Not sure, Bumbo, just take whatever you want. Not like we needed anything. Take Fate for flying, although I could have probably and should have probably waited on that. Okay, well now it doesn't matter. And try Zerger down. There we go. Get the Nail, Book of Belial, and the Necronomicon. Roll it again. Oh my goodness. Chocolate Milk, Proptosis, Deadeye, Halo, Compound Fracture, Halo of Flies, Lead Pencil, as well as Sacrificial Altar, which I will use right now. That also gives us Void, and it gives us Pentagram. Now, I do not recommend using Void on the D Infinity. This gives us Bookworm as well. I think we could probably roll with this. I just realized that we could have fought Hush. Well, I don't know if I would have wanted to fight Hush there. Let's see how well we do here. I have a feeling this is going to be quite powerful. I mean, it's Chocolate Milk Proptosis. The Chocolate Milk will basically make us have to pulse, or essentially we have to manually fire now, which is kind of annoying. And also, if you have a mechanical keyboard like I do, it tends to show up on the microphone quite often and annoy people. So hopefully you can't really hear it that well. But the biggest benefit about Chocolate Milk, though, is the fact that you can charge your item and shoot out huge tiers for a whole lot more damage than the small ones. And we also have number 2. Thank you, Fate's Reward. But when Deadeye kicks in, holy moly, that is a lot of damage. And remember, we're Guppy, so the more flies that we create, the more damage we're going to do. It's pretty destructive combo here. But do we stick with it? That's the thing. Do we want to stick with it? Oh, we also have sulfuric acid, apparently. We may have explosion immunity? Let's find out. That wasn't due to the ghost, that was due to us. Or that was due to the ghost, not to us. Okay, we do not have explosion immunity. Oh my goodness. Get absolutely melted, Isaac. Yeah, we'll go fight Delirium, since I didn't fight Hush. I mean, we've got 9 lives. We're Guppy. As long as I don't reroll this run, we'll be fine. I do wish we had Polar Invincibility, though. Deadeye, by the way, is the reason why all the tears start glowing. The more consecutive times you hit a target, the more damage you get from Deadeye. Gonna be Cage. Oh, God. Yeah. That's the damage that we're looking at right here. Cage and double cage didn't last even more than, I think, a second and a half. That is a lot of damage we're dealing. Yeah. We're looking pretty darn good. I am going to drop the D-Infinity so I don't accidentally hit the space bar. And we'll just stick with this for the rest of the run. But again, thank you, everybody. I really do appreciate everyone tuning in. I know that people have been posting very nice comments, especially with the Edenversary video. Thank you all very much, by the way, for making that the most liked video I've got. Tied with the Super Fight video that TB allowed me to do a long time ago. But the thing is, that video has been out for 3 years. This video, the Edenversary one, has been out for 3 days, and you all crushed it. So thank you all very, very much. We need to stop losing HP here. Just because we're super strong doesn't mean we can't die to Delirium. Let's not get cocky, kid. Without Polar and Invincibility, Delirium is never a surefire thing. And there is Butt Bomb. Well, luckily we got it back, but that's where we've been getting hit from. We've been getting hit because I haven't noticed that Chocolate Milk and Number 2 are actually quite terrible for each other, especially if you're not paying attention if you lay the bombs or not. Oh, we found Delirium, so we have a full charge on the Book of Shadows, which is good. I mean, I'm not expecting to lose here, but we just need to be a little bit careful. When he gets down to about 50%, that's when we're going to probably charge him and pop the Book of Shadows. So we'll have probably a ton of flies after that. Ah, Delirium Matriarch. All right, pop Book of Shadows. We're going to bum rush him here with the flies. There we go. We did it. So, hey, look at that. We took a pretty good run and turned it into something fun. Thanks to the D-Infinity. Thank you for watching, everyone. Like I said, hope you had a great start to your Friday. Make sure you click the like button if you enjoyed this video. Click the dislike if you didn't. Let's see that streak go. And can we push up to 2,000 likes for the second time in 1 week? That would also be a channel first. Sure hope so. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing, everyone. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!